Conan, please meet Ficky.
I'm sorry, it's Ficky. Is that right?
Yeah, it's like Vicky with an F, so Ficky. Yeah, you were saying it
that
right.
That is so cool. I've never heard that name before. I love an interesting name. That's a very cool name.
It means my beloved in Amharic.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm.
You know what Conan means in Gaelic?
What?
Wide face.
So both of those are absolutely right.
Basically, yeah. Yours is right and mine is right. Well, Ficky, and you are a chess champion, right?
Yes. I've been playing since I was 8.
Did you love the Queen's Gambit, or were you kind of annoyed that she learned how to play chess by staring at a ceiling?
That was a bit weird when people were like, oh, do you do that too? I was like, no. But I mean, it's a good film. All the games are real because I've like mm-hmm. paused it, and I've been that annoying person who's like, let me look at this.
That's cool. You would pause Queen's Gambit and check out the pieces and make sure that like, oh, I see what they're doing. Yes, this is an actual move.
A lot of films use like, oh, this person's playing chess means they're smart. But half of the time it's like, the moves aren't correct at all.
Yes, that's what it would happen if I made a TV show and a character yes. was playing chess. You'd look down and you'd notice some of those aren't even chess pieces.
There's a thimble.
It's a monopoly.
There's a thimble, yeah. There's a little horsey from like a plastic horsey set. There's a G.I. Joe. Yeah, that's what you would find out. I also think one of the things I notice in Queen's Gambit is that she hits this part of her life where she has a different outfit change that's stunning for every single chess move. Like mm-hmm. she'll move her chess piece and then she'll say, I'll be right back. Now it's time for Prada. I found that to be a little strange. Where are you right now?
Well, my background's the United Nations.
I see that. Yeah, I love that. I love that wow. you're a United Nations background. It looks like, you know what it looks like? It looks like you're you're a supervillain who's appearing before the United Nations to tell them they have 24 hours.
Yes.
You have 24 hours to meet my demands or that sky will rain giant chess pieces.
Just to be clear, that's not what you're doing, right?
No.
Okay, no, that's good. Where in the world are you right now?
I'm in New York City.
Oh, cool. All right. You're in New York City.
Mm-hmm.
You must have been playing chess early because chess players, they practically start in utero, mm-hmm. right?
They kind of have to. That's a lot of the Russians.
So you were playing against Russian champions when you were still unborn.
Yes.
That's really impressive. So you just kick the stomach wall a couple of times for a code,
oh my God.
And that means...
Mom plays this move.
Yeah, mom play this move. Now mom play that move. That is, wow. That is impressive. So how early did you know? Really, as far back as you can remember, you mm-hmm. knew chess? Chess is your superpower?
Well, I could play with the boys and get hurt, which I didn't want to do. I could sit with the kids who didn't do their homework, which was kind of awkward to do. So my teacher was teaching chess and I just sat, and I remember I didn't get it at all, but he was just really nice to me and he kept teaching me. So every choice time I would go over to the chess table with like three other boys.
I remember thinking very clearly, I can't play with the boys because I'll get hurt. I remember that very clearly.
They're aggressive, even in third grade.
Boys are the worst, trust me. I realized then that I didn't, you know, this is even going back to like kickball, which is supposed to be the easiest sport. I remember trying to kick the kickball and missing and everyone laughing at me and deciding I need to do something else and I need to be elsewhere right now. But I applaud that. I applaud that you found your passion so early. So what are you doing now? What are you working on?
Trying to pass college.
Pass college? Everybody passes college.
Well,
yeah. Do you see the people that pass college every day? Yeah, there's no passing college. You're going to pass college. You are a brilliant person, you know? You can lie in your cot at night and look at the ceiling and imagine chess moves. I know you can.
I wish I could do that with tests and answers.
Where do you go to school?
Bates College in Lewiston, Maine.
It's cold up there.
Mm-hmm. I'm at home right now. I'm going to go back after I get my second vaccine. So,
oh, you got the vaccine?
Yes, I did. New York, I was okay. eligible.
That's cool.
Podcasters are eligible. I know that.
Well, I'm here to tell you as a podcaster, no, we're not. That's just what I want to do is show up in a long line in LA and go, excuse me, I'm a podcaster. That's not going to happen. You should suddenly see a tall, redheaded pinata getting beaten. But I'm glad you're getting vaccinated. I'm really happy about that. Mm-hmm. You're a very cool person. You're very smart. You are a delight. And you're just, you know, you're there in front of the United Nations. Yeah. They have to meet your demands. Mm-hmm. I like the whole thing.
The moment I saw her background, I was like, oh, she's cool.
I know. I thought that was like an international chess match or something.
Many people think the UN does engage in international chess.
Oh, okay.
I actually went to the UN for a chess conference type of thing. Judith Polgar, she was encouraging other girls to play chess because most girls stop around high school, college.
Right, right. They can get almost phobic or steered away from math because they think it's, well, that's not really what I should be doing or spending my energy on, which is, you know, terrible and should be that. I think that's changing. I think it's changing quickly. Mm-hmm. I think people like you are changing it. So.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. Well, that's what I do. I dispense compliments to people that deserve them. My name's Conan O'Brien. Not you,
Sonia. That's what I'm going to
do. Yeah. What? Well, really nice talking to you. I love your name.
Oh, thank you.
I'm going to remember that name and I'm going to use it to steal your identity.
In a murder?
No, it's
you said that hopefully.
Yeah. No, just cash missing from your account.
Oh,
you'll see.
Oh, dang.
Yeah, I do it. This is pretty much a scam.
Oh.
I get people to give me their information and then they later on find out, hey, how come I never heard myself on Conan's podcast? And how come $7,000 is missing from my account? Well, nice talking to you. Thank you, Ficky.
Yeah. I have one last thing because it's
yes.
My roommate. Okay, so it's around the time of Halloween. And so we were watching The Ring and I got your mug. Have you seen your Conan O'Brien Needs a Friend mug?
I think I saw one once.
I can show you. It's
How does it relate to The Ring, the movie The Ring?
We watched it and then it was around the same time I got the mug. And then so my roommate has LED lights. So it just started completely flashing. And then my desk started to shake. So my roommate thinks this mug is cursed. So if you...
The mug?
Bring it back.
Wait a minute. She's saying that the Conan O'Brien Needs a Friend mug that you purchased online is cursed. She seriously is banning the mug from...
I don't know how to sage it, or should I put googly eyes on the mug?
No, do not put googly eyes on my mug. That's demeaning and will make me look like some sort of absurd character. I can't believe that your roommate is so narrow-minded that she would think that anything with my face on it invokes evil.
It's also just a bit like creepy just because it's these like two like really piercing blue eyes just staring at you.
Yes. When they said, what kind of mug do you want? I said, I want one that captures the real me. And all the women on staff agreed that I'm a creepy staring guy, and that immediately became the mug. So I'm sorry. I'm sorry that if you think the mug is cursed, I don't think I can lift that curse. I think if it's cursed, it's cursed. Sonia, why are you laughing?
They were watching The Ring, and then they thought that your mug was cursed. It's just her roommate won't allow it back into the house. There's so many things about this I love so much that you just invoke this evil just from a cartoon portrait of yourself.
Or is it just the roommate doesn't want it in her view, so she's saying it's haunted. We gotta get it.
Yeah, is it because we're finding out that a lot of people are coming up with excuses not to want that mug around. And so it could be that she doesn't believe the mug is cursed. She just doesn't like seeing my face. And I've had a lifetime of people saying, I'd rather your face wasn't here
now.
Oh, it's true. True story. True story.
My room is also on top of the laundromat, so it might explain why my bed's shaking. My desk is shaking.
Oh, wow.
I'm still going to say it's the cup. I'm sorry.
They thought it was the mug before it was the laundromat downstairs.
You live above a laundromat, and you're blaming my mug for the room shaking?
I'd rather a cursed mug.
You're like, well, there is a rodeo downstairs. I forgot to mention that. We live above a theater that's been showing Hereditary around the clock 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for 2 years. But my my roommate says your mug is cursed. Well, my beef is with your roommate. I say it's not cursed.
Okay,
but if it is cursed, I hereby lift that curse.
Yay.